The issue of climate change and its impact on Caribbean economies has caused development planners lots of worry over the past few years. But now the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States is trying to mitigate the risks of climate change by identifying the threats and adapting to the changes in the natural environment. The OECS launched the Reducing Risk to Human and Natural Assets Resulting from Climate Change project here today, with a $4 million contribution from the United States Agency for International Development.
Our adaptation money is very directed towards making sure that we're not only directly looking for the impacts of climate change that are happening in the region and working to prevent or to diminish those impacts, but to integrate that across our development portfolio. It's very important to recognize that climate change adaptation funding is not just an environment issue. It's an economic growth issue, it's a food security issue, it's a global health issue, it's a water issue, etc. So as this very important program is being implemented, we're looking to make sure that we learn from the experiences on the ground and apply those lessons learned to the work that we're doing in other small island developing nations across the world.
While the OECS believes the resources will never be adequate to address the problem, the Secretariat is encouraged that member states have understood the importance of dealing with the issue.
We'll be applying the funding to demonstrating the type of results we expect from adaptation initiatives. And of course, with the funding that's made available through USAID to the countries, we can see this going a very long way towards attaining the types of goals that we see necessary. The resources provided by USAID is good, very timely, limited, mind you, but then it will go a long way to securing the kind of changes, the catalyst changes that we see as necessary. We will require a whole lot more to do everything as required.
James Goggin is the USAID representative for the Eastern Caribbean and Barbados, and he is very confident about the success of the program. He bases his optimism on past experience and the input of stakeholder consultations for the project.
We know from experience, from good experience, that we can work very successfully through the OECS Secretariat to get down to the member states. We had a very successful project, as other speakers mentioned, over the last few years on biodiversity conservation. And we were able to work through the Secretariat and at the member state level simultaneously. We found those stakeholder conversations so dynamic and so positive that, as Keith Nichols has mentioned, we've already seen the member states seizing this project as their own, and they are full of ideas, very full of practical applications of our adaptation funding. So I think we're already having success in this project.
The project will address four major areas: barriers to mitigating the risks of climate change, investment in coastal resources and water, setting up technical training for Caribbean people,